actors from EDUB's latest movie project, Jonathan Maldonado and Drew Mutali, to talk about their characters in Breakeven. So how are you guys today?
Very good, very good. How are you?
I'm pretty good, myself. So tell me a little bit about your character, Jonathan.
So my character's name's Evan, and he's pretty much your average, ordinary guy. He's funny. He's a little clown, a little class clown, if you could say that. But he, at the same time, is really shy, and he's trying to get his friend that he actually likes. He has a lot of feelings for to go to him, go with him to the prom, and that's pretty much what the whole movie revolves around.
And how about you, Drew? Can you tell me some characteristics of Jerome?
For me, the character Jerome is more of a self-centered guy. He's quiet, really doesn't want to socialize with anyone. All he cares about is himself and football, and pretty much like going to parties and doing all this crazy stuff. So yeah.
Kind of materialistic.
Yeah. I mean, he's really crazy. He pretty much can do whatever he wants. He's like his own, he's a god or something like that in his own world. So yeah, that's a picture of him.
So, do you guys relate to your characters?
Well, in some ways I do, and in some ways I don't. And with the shyness part of him, like not being able to open up to people a lot, like very easily in a fast amount of time, it takes him a while to get close to people. I think that's sort of, in a way, can be like me at times, but overall, I think we're kind of two different people, in my opinion, at least.
For me, I believe it's the same case. For me, Jerome is more like, you know, self-centered. I'm not self-centered myself. I'm very social. I talk to a lot of people. I'm not that tough. I can be tough, but not just tough and rude to anyone. But for Jerome, he's tough, he's rude, he doesn't really care about anyone. So, yeah, we're two different people when it comes to that.
Would you say it was hard to act those people because of the differences?
Oh yeah, it was hard. It was hard to, like, be able to separate yourself from your character.
Yeah, just being someone different that you're really, being someone else that you're really not, like.
Yeah, it's so, like, oh.
Was this your guys' first time acting?
Yeah, for me it was my first time. And I mean, we came into it with like zero experience in acting. But I think coming out of it, we got a little experience with it. It's been a good ride, I think.
Is it something you guys would want to do again, or is acting something either of you want to pursue?
I would want to do it again, like just as a side job or part-time thing, but not really as a main focus.
Yeah, same for me. I would do it like I would do it. I would do it for like just for fun, you know, and see where it goes, wherever it takes me. Yeah.
So let's start with you, Jonathan. Did you have a favorite part or a favorite scene in the movie?
Well, yeah, I think for both of us. The fight scene was probably our favorite scene, and just because it was really like it took a lot of practice to get down, and it was just a tough scene to do overall, but it was fun. You get a lot of movement,
we punched each other. Yeah. It was pretty funny,
We actually have a clip from that scene, so let's play that now.
It is because of Brenda, isn't it? Look, man, this problem we're having is between you and me, not Brenda, not Chelsea. Just you?
First of all,
don't fucking touch me. And when you got a problem with me, you come pick it up with me. Because Chelsea has nothing to do with this, all right? Oh. Get off me! Stop!
So was that a hard scene for you guys to film, being such close friends, pretending to be angry with each other?
Yeah, see, we're friends, you know? We've been best friends since I came here last year. And, but it was fun to, you know, beat him up a little bit, you know, teach him who's boss, you know. But, yeah, it was pretty difficult to stay serious with it, you know. We had to do it a lot of times. We'd, like, get all mad, put our mad faces on, and then start laughing at each other.
Were there any other scenes that were particularly interesting or hard to do?
Oh, yeah. The kissing scene. That was most impressive. funny to watch.
Yeah, it was just an awkward kind of thing, you know, because being that we're not professional actors, like I said, you know, it was our first time doing something like this, and then to just go randomly and kiss someone, you know. But it came out right. It came out good. So, you know, it's not, you can't. It's kissing. Nothing bad about it. You know, it's a good thing.
And so, overall experience, how was it? Would you do it again? And was it enjoyable?
It was fun. It was a fun project to do, and I would do it again. The director is a really good director. Tremendous crew and cast. You know.
Yeah, I'd definitely like to do it again, you know. It was a pretty fun experience, and it's something that, you know, it's like a once-in-a-lifetime thing. You're not gonna, when's the next time we're gonna make a movie, you know? So, and if, I'm actually interested in actually making another movie, because, like I said, it's our first one, and I'm just, you know, I'm looking forward to seeing what we can do, how good we can get, you know?
Okay, thank you guys. After this break, we will talk to director and writer Jason Anafi.
So, I was wondering if...
Are you out of your mind?
Look, I'm serious, okay? It's not a joke. Why would I even lie to you about this?
Maybe because you're jealous.
Chelsea.
Just trust me, okay?
Hey, Jerome!
I have no idea what you're talking about. Would you please go to the phone?
Why don't you just go to the phone?
Jason Anafi here with us to talk about writing and directing the movie Break Even. Jason, can you tell me a bit about the movie Break Even, about the story plot, and a little bit about the characters?
Well, Break Even is just like a typical high school movie. Well, just because we're doing it here, it's a typical high school movies. And it has like five characters in the movie. And it's a story about this girl, Chelsea, revolves around her, who is trying to do whatever it takes to make Evan realize that she likes him. Because kind of like Evan is dumb. He cannot see that she likes him. But part of this is that she's going out with Jerome just to make Evan jealous. And also she's planning to dump Jerome because Jerome is kind of like a jerk in this school, although he's a jerk and he's popular. All the girls like him, but he's kind of like self-centered. He doesn't care about anybody. And yeah, it's just a typical high school movie about romance, typical high school romance, drama.
Was there a specific event or something in particular that inspired this movie or the idea for this movie?
Okay, what normally inspires me is my environment. Wherever I find myself in, I try to just imagine, just picture something's going on, and I try to write a script about it. And what inspired me about this school is because I just liked how the school was, and there were a lot of people who I just like randomly saw that these people could be really good actors because the way they pretend and the way they do certain things. I was like, okay, it's really great. Let me just write a script about it. And I spoke to the principal of the school, and he was like, all right, just go ahead, just do it. And my advice on Mr. Min, yeah, he gave me a really tough time writing the script because I took like a month or two to write the script. I kept on writing and writing and kept on changing certain things. But what inspired me most were just the fact that everybody was like, okay, just go ahead, we believe in you, and just do it.
Was this your first time directing and writing?
Well, writing, this is not my first time writing. I've written like more than 7 full-length movies. Well, not all of them have been produced yet, but I've written a couple of full-length movies and a couple of short films. this is not my first time in directing. This is certainly not my first time directing, but this is kind of like my first time directing major project like this, a project that took more than 3 months. He also said, this is my first time directing a project like this.
Is it something you want to continue and pursue as a future career?
Certainly, yeah, obviously I want to continue this, I want to keep on doing it. Probably be win an Oscar, I mean, like an award. Be one of the best, maybe the directors, because, well, I'm not thinking about being a producer yet, but yeah, probably maybe one of the best directors and writers. Yeah, I want to continue this.
When will it be finished, or has it finished already?
Well, it just finished. We got done yesterday, and I'm so happy we just finished this one because it was hustle. It was too much work. I mean, always being on set after school. Since we're students, we have to schedule our time that after school some of us are working. So, and sometimes time collides. Sometimes there are a lot of things that are happening that some actors just don't show up and you have to go around looking for them. It takes you an hour to find them and you come back and another actor just left set. So I'm just happy that we're done with this. It's happy.
Is there a way that students here can be involved?
Well, yeah, I would say, because even though we're done with the filming, we're not done with everything. I mean, like some of the students here are involved in photography, or the photo shoots and stuff of the movie. Those of you who know, maybe let's say, editing out there, yeah, we have our chief editor who could maybe walk you through, teach you what to do, so that it makes things a little bit faster for all of us, so we can get done, so that everybody can see the movie.
And now back to the movie, is there a message that you want to be relayed after watching this movie? Is something that the viewers should take with them?
Okay, so I would say my favorite character is Jerome, okay? Even though he's like the self-centered person, he doesn't care about anybody, or he's a jock, and he's kind of a mean guy, but I would say don't be like Jerome, okay? Don't be like Jerome, because friendship is very important. Jerome and Evan were best friends, but they got split up because of a girl, because Jerome liked a girl, and the girl ended up with Evan, got split up. So friendship is very important, because throughout the movie, you can see that some friends, like we have characters like Isabella. Isabella is looking out for her friend Chelsea. We have Doran. Doran is looking out for Evelyn. So the only person who doesn't have someone looking out for him is Jerome in the movie. So friendship is really important in this movie.
Would you say that this message was inspired from things that you've seen at the school, or more just life experience?
Well, yeah, in a way, from things I've seen at this school, because as many of you may know, I'm not American, I'm Ghanaian, I'm from a country in West Africa. And over there, every country has a different way of culture. And over here, when I came to high school, this is the first place I've seen that when students are like together, they're always in a circle. Like, you go through the hallways and you see students in the circle, and sometimes you can't even fit in the circle because you go, you're like, there's no space for you. You realize that there's a lot of friendship, closeness. Sometimes you see, anywhere you see one person, you can see the other person. So maybe if I'm looking for, let's say, a guy named Jordan, I could see Tyler there because Jordan is Tyler's friend. So all I got to do is just find where Jordan is and I could find Tyler. So I was inspired by how things are done here in this group.
Do you have any last thoughts about your movie? Anything you want to share with the audience?
What do I want to share with the audience? Watch this movie. Okay? You should all watch this movie because we have put a lot of work into it. It's a short film. It probably should have taken like a month or something, but it took us like 3 to 4 months just to make it perfect for Edmund Sudway. This is our first movie we're doing, so Edmund Sudway, students out there, tell your parents. I don't know, I haven't decided. Well, I'm not part of the marketing department yet, but our producers, what I heard is just a leak. It's just a leak, don't tell anybody, but I heard they're gonna premiere this movie, so when they premiere, I want everybody to be there. I don't know where, but wherever it's gonna be, you should all be there.
Thank you for your time, Jason. His movie is called Break Even, and you guys should definitely all check it out. I'm Kiana Tipton.